Hello everyone, welcome to this session on Field Orientation Control Made Easy. My name is Xiangchuan Li, I'm the Application Engineer at the MathWorks, based in Dallas, Texas. Before I joined MathWorks, I worked for my PhD at UW-Madison in Wisconsin. My specialty is in motor control and powertronics. So in this talk, we will show you how to spin brushless motors using model-based design in Simulink. To be more specific, we will walk you through how to develop a control algorithm in Simulink and generate embedded code from the model. So let me show you how to develop and implement field orientation control with Simulink and model-based design. So to frame our discussion, we will use this very simplified workflow covered by these key steps. So and for today's presentation, we are gonna use TIC 2000 motor control kit to illustrate the workflow. The kits include a service mount, motors, F2AX series microcontroller, and DRV A305 three-phase inverter. So we will start with the sensor calibration by measuring phase current using ABC. Calibrating current offset is essential to ensure accurate current measurement. With the motor control block set, we provide the reference example for ABC offset calibration. The reference example includes the model that we can generate a code and download to the processor and the host model control the target. As you can see here, we are start with the disconnect the motor from the inverter to make sure there are no phase current going through the motor. So the model we generate a code from can capture ADC counts and send them over through serial port to the host model. By reading the mean value of the signals, the offset of the phase A and phase B current are shown here around 2300. Finally, we enter those offset into the MATLAB script so that we will use them later for closed-loop control. Next, we will compute the position sensor offset. The kit that we provide can calibrate for both Hall sensor and quadrature encoder. But here, we are using Hall sensor as an example. For those of you who are interested in sensors field orientation control, you could definitely skip this step. So we will start with the model that we will generate a code from by specifying a power supply voltage, which is 20 volts in this case. The idea of the model runs open loop control to compute the position sensor offset, and the whole sensor takes the reading until the position is commanded to be 0 degrees at this moment. Then we will generate a code from this model and download to our processor. We then use the host model to start the calibration. After that, we click this run button and start calibrating. We will see the motor will start spinning and the offset will be automatically computed. Now the green LED here shows the motor is spinning in the right direction, which is counterclockwise. If not, the motor spins in clockwise direction. The LED turns red, indicating we need to swap the wires between the motor and the inverter. So our next step is parameter estimation for the brushless motor. As we know, an accurate plane model helps us better design for our controller in the closed loop simulation. In our case, we already have an actual motor, and we can take advantage of that. So with a motor control block set, it provides instrument tests we can run on the processor to estimate motor parameters. Another nice thing is we have a host model to control and monitor the progress of parameter estimation. So let's see how it works. So we start with a host model which serves as a user interface. Here we define all the parameters, nominal voltage, current speed, and input DC bus voltage. We also define the home sensor offset based on the previous computed value. Once we have defined all this value, then we go to the target model and update the value from the instrument test to generate a code. We then start parameter estimation from the host model. Tests are run on the motor to estimate stator resistance, inductance, LD and LQ, back EMF, back EMF constant, moment of inertia, and friction coefficient. So it's going to take around 30 seconds to finish the estimation process. And now we can use a provided scope to examine the signal of our interest. Like here, we're looking at the speed. Now that the parameter has been estimated, we can save them into a file. If we load this file in a MATLAB, we will see a structure with the estimated motor parameter values. Later, we can use these values for accurate closed-loop FOC simulation and loop tuning. So we have seen motor control blockset parameter estimation capabilities, which are handy if you already have motor hardware. However, sometimes you have to start development before hardware is available. In that case, you can import motor parameters from a datasheet, parameterize motor from FEA tools such as JMAC or ANSYS Maxwell, or even from our dyno data. There are plenty of examples and capabilities using ThinkScape Electrical and other products can help you to do that. So with ThinkScape Electrical, we are not only can model the physical component, but also model different level fidelity for different purposes. What I mean here is, if you are a system architecture engineer, you probably only focus on system level simulation. So you can use long parameters to model the entire distributed power plant, for example. And if you are an electrical engineer who is only focused on component level, spice level simulation, you can include the nonlinear model to see the saturation and harmonics effect. And the trade-off is for long parameter linear model that allow you to run faster simulation. As for detailed modeling considering nonlinear effect, it will take a longer time but allow you to have realistic simulation result. Okay, now I would like to show you a demo. How do we model inverter in different fidelity? As we can see from the demo, we have our motor parameters that we just measured from the experiment, so we can model motor and inverter dynamics. In this model, we have set up three variants for modeling motor and inverter. In the first variant, we use blocks from motor control blockset for modeling linear long parameter motor dynamics with a fixed inductance value by directly loading estimated motor parameters into the block. So for fast simulation, we can model inverter as an average value device. As for the second variant, for those of you who are interested in switching event in the power electronics, we can use ThinkScape Electrical to model the gate signals for the inverter. Now we are modeling ideal switch inverter, but we can also model power semiconductors such as MOSFET or IGBTs.